Hello engineers, today I am going to talk about snakes, I mean splines, and some people also call it splines. I actually don't know what should I call it, splines or spline. Let me know what you think, what should I call it, spline or spline. And today I am going to talk about everything about spline. And before I start this tutorial, I want to tell you that this trick was, this spline command was created to draw any smooth objects such as bonnet of car and some other corridor shapes. So without wasting time, let's draw these splines. Well, you can use spline from here. Just click here to use spline, and if you want to use command line, then keyboard shortcut for spline is SPL. Then simply press enter. Then there are basically two methods to draw spline. First one is fit and second one is CV. So first I will explain what is basic difference between fit and CV. So first I will use ear fit. Let's draw ear fit. This is fit. I will enter here, and then now I will use ear CV. So let me show you how CV works. So let me show you the points. As you can see here, it follows the points in fit, and in CV it get influenced by those points but don't follow those points exactly. So this is basic difference between fit and CV. This is point where I clicked, and this is second point, third point, fourth point, second, third, fourth point, second, fourth, fifth, second, third, fourth, fifth. Okay, so I think now you understand what is basic difference between fit and CV. So now I will explain what are some different things. Let's take example of this. This is way of editing, but I will tell you how to edit this spline in next video. So in this video I will tell you how to draw a spline properly. Actually I think now you already know, but there are some other things which you should know about splines. So let's draw here another spline. I will choose here fit. Now you can see here option of and tangency. So you might be wondering what is the function of and tangency. So let me show you. Let's keep here mouse point, and then I will simply enter here this spline. Now I will use your spline again. This time I will end tangency here. So I think now you understand difference between end tangency. If I will keep my mouse cursor upper side, then it will give curve this like this, and if I will keep my cursor in the bottom, then it will give curved shape like this. So this is how it works. Let's delete this. There is some other things which I want to tell you in this video. I will use your feet again. As you can see here is tolerance, but before I use here tolerance, I want to draw some long line. As you can see here, when I move my cursor, whole entire SP line is moving. But if I increase your value of tolerance, if I give your value of tolerance 10, right now value of tolerance is 0. Let's give your value 10. As you can see here, I think now you understand what happens when we increase the value of tolerance. It simply increase the value of tolerance, but I normally prefer 0 tolerance while drawing. So I think you know most of things about drawing polyline, but there are some basic things about polyline, SP line, which you should know. In order to understand that, I have to select this SP line, and these are those points where I clicked, but because of tolerance it got moved. And if I hold my cursor right here, then it will show you some another options. Same thing happen in SP line CV. Right now we are drawing here SP line feet. So let's erase this so I can explain for SP line CV and feet both. This is SP line feet. Now I will draw here SP line CV so you can understand it properly. Let's select both of the line. When I hold my cursor here, then it will show here three options: stretch feet point, add feet point, remove feet point. And if I will feel like this line should be little more above this point and little more below this point, then I can do that by clicking on stretch point. And if I will simply select this line, and then I can simply move this line like this. I can stretch this line like this. So this is how we can do in speed, and same thing you can do in the CV, but you don't have to hold your cursor right here. You have to hold your cursor here and then simply stretch this as you want, as you require. And there is one other option, add point. Actually, if you want to stretch line from here, but there is no point is available here, so you cannot stretch line from here. But if you will add here stretch point, add feet point, I will add feet point here. Let's as you can see here, now I can move it like this. Let's add another feet point. So this is how you can add feet point. Same thing you can do for CV. Add vertex. You can add vertex as a wherever you want. So there are some other options. Remove feet point. If you will remove it, if you want to remove this point, then you can remove it from here. Just click on remove vertex in CV. So I think now you understand lots of things about splines. So this is it for today. Next time I will talk about how to edit these SP lines. Thanks for watching.